Hi everyone, how's it going? So I have a very large album to show you today. It is a 10-pager, but before I get started, I don't have the paper pad with me, but I have used it several times. It is the Desert Dreams paper pad by Recollections. If you just type in Desert Dreams and my username, I have a lot of different albums made with it. And so anyways, this is just a custom album I made for my cousin, the one who ordered the Mother's Day album. She wanted this exact style of album. She actually sent me a picture of a towel that she bought, a hand towel that she bought for her kitchen. And she was like, oh, hey, you know, can you make me an album with this kind of theme? And I was like, oh my gosh, I have exactly that type of paper and color scheme. And so anyways, let's go ahead and get started talking about the album. So the album itself, the cover is 9 by 6.5, and the inside is 8.5 by 6 inches. So it's a good photo to fit a lot of different size of pictures in it. The only thing she wanted was extra pages, so it is a 10-pager, as you can see right here. We have all the paper, all the paper here. And so let's go ahead and get a close-up of this cover. So she did want a cattle skull or deer skull or something like that in the front. So I found this little wood chip or a wood thing, thewoodstore.com. I recommend you guys go look at that because they have a lot of awesome laser cut wood shapes for a very cheap price. And so anyways, I added a doily with some handmade flowers and some other roses that I had in my collection. And then this Heidi Swap, I believe, the font, and that is wood as well. So as you can see, it's all very thick there. And then for the spine, I found, instead of glitter canvas, I actually found glitter foam, so I wanted to try this out. It was easier to work with because it's more pliable, and the glitter is less chunky than the actual canvas. So I went to Hobby Lobby and I found both, but I bought a few of these just to try out because they do come in larger sheets for around the same price. And then I also found this at Hobby Lobby that I thought was perfect to add on to the bow. So here is the back. 90% of the paper is from the Desert Dreams paper stack, but like stuff like this is just kind of random stuff I had in my collection. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm so excited because this album is so freaking beautiful. And so anyways, for this cover, you can actually put a photo right here, but it is just like the little desert scenery right here, or the, you know, you could even do some journaling right there. And then for this front page, it's a see-through and vellum pocket. So the front part of the frame is acetate, and the back part is actually pink vellum. So that's what that looks like. And then these are just some photo mats that I included in there. So there we go. Put that back in there. And then here is that vellum back part of the pocket. I will show you. See, there's my fingers just sewn through. And then even though it's 10 pages, it actually has more spots for photos because I wanted it to be really, really fun. And so anyways, I just did a vertical belly band, and then I just added a collage of clip art that I had in my stash. And then these are just more photo mats. There we go. And then when we open it this way, a spot for photos here, spot for photos here. And so the clip art that I had, I tried to make it all cohesive with the paper pad. And then, oh, it's just so beautiful. I love looking at it. But anyways, here's a spot for a photo here. And then if you can't tell, on top this lettering says family gathering. And then this is pop dotted. I don't have a picture to show you, but it is a rope frame that I got from the old Western cartridge. And then this is a little stamp that I had in my collection. And oh my gosh, so many elements to this album. So for this page, I have a little wood sticker that I got. I think it's like Jolie's Boutique or something like that, the ones they just sell at Joann's. And then I just have a little foam leaf right here, so you can put a photo up here. And then when you open it up, another spot for a photo here. And then a spot for 3x3 photos right here, and then I just little tried to make them flat embellishments so that way this can close well without having it to be too bulky. And so this pattern, I love this pattern. It's just so colorful and so fun. I just added some little wood embellishments right up there, of course, with some sticker collage. And then yeah, so sometimes I trick myself because some of these have flaps that flap out. I think I made 3 of the pages that flip out into extra pages. So anyways, this is just a little pocket with some some photo mats there. And then this one just says happy day with the little Broncos in the back. And then here's just a little dollar store sticker I had in my collection. And then these are all just spots for I believe 4x4 photos. So yeah, you can fit 7 in there. And then so here's another one that extends 2 extra pages. And I had, for some reason, when I did my last album, I had an extra Cricut cut of this. It was from the Old West cartridge. And I just added some gold little letters that I had in my stash. And just kind of cracked me up because I just set myself up for success for this album. So anyways, look at this gold cattle paper with the horns. I just love that. And then when we open this page, I have a little flap right here that a 4x6 photo can just be slapped on right there. And then again over here, and over here I just added a little bit of hexagons. Do you think that's what they are? Yes, 6 sides hexagons. And I love this little arrows. These arrows, this probably is my favorite paper from the entire collection. And then over here I got another one of those rope frames. I cut 3 of them out so that way it can kind of just tie all in together if I put them in there sporadically. And then this hay bale is the same as the front, and all I did is they're from the Old West cartridge as well, and all I did was kind of add a little bit of yellow marker to add depth to the paper. And then I added some diamond glaze on the straps of these, the brown hay bales. And then some more clip art I just layered. And these are, that's not open in the back. So it'll fit a 4x6 right here, though. I know that. And then I just added a little bit of words right there. And then here is another little waterfall page. It says sweet. And then it's magnetic, so it closes shut. And then again, another 7 photos. So she can fit tons and tons of photos. She's actually bought a few from me in the last few weeks. And she just told me that she just loves putting pictures in them. And so I'm very happy that she's able to enjoy them as much as I enjoy making them. And so anyways, here is a horizontal belly band that I made, and again with one of those wood chip stickers from the Jolie brand that you saw before. And then here's another one of those rope frames. I believe this is the last one, but I just had a little rose down here with the word beauty. And then over here I just added a giant doily to kind of make these pages more cohesive. And then, of course, a glitter border with some clip art, some more, a little, these are actually cut from the actual paper, and then I just pasted them on a gold frame, and then just a little collage of little things that were, you know, scraps from here and there. Alright, and so for this page, I added a little fence that I cut out from the Old West collection, you know, cactuses, roses. There's some little canvas stickers I had, some little wood chip stickers I had. So it has a lot of really fun fun embellishments and elements in here. And then, of course, I have to have the word adventures in here because, you know, she's always going on adventures. And then, of course, that's another little pocket. And the good thing about pockets is you can always stuff more photos in there if, you know, they're kind of an odd size or they just don't fit. You know, or you ran out of photo mats, so lots and lots of space for photos. So for this one, I added a little spot for wallet photos here. There we go. So it'll fit 3 of, yeah. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, 4 of them. And then this one, I really love this geometric print of this wood paper. I just thought it was so beautiful. And because there was already some stuff going on right here, I didn't add anything to this paper, so she can even fit 5x7 on there. And, you know, the picture will be showing in the background and it'll still look very, very beautiful. And so on this page, I added another little one of those skulls up here with some roses around it. So there's going to be a spot for a photo up there. And then for the last page, it is just another little flap. I like the look of this little, it's craft cardstock, and I just inked the edges. It kind of looked like old Western paper. So when we open it up, I have some, I don't know if you can tell, the goldish foil paper here. And then just some more, a collage of flowers, and then up here as well. So it'll fit lots and lots of photos, definitely lots of pop dots that were in there. There's the top, so it's a pretty large album, but once she puts the pictures in there, you know, there's still enough space for them to fit. So anyways, I hope you guys like the album. I hope she likes it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And surprise, surprise, I'm working on another album right now. So you guys have a wonderful day, and we'll see you again soon. Bye.